gon' be alright.
Hey, all things work together good.
We gon' be alright.
Tom Tom Gang brought me on New England.
We gon' be alright.
Hey, I ain't worried about it.
Oh no.
Don't you worry.
Good evening and welcome back, iMac and friends. We have a special guest today, one of our very own iMac youth members, Dylan. Dylan, it's good to have you here.
It's good to be here.
Good. Today's topic is, who do you idolize? And our memory verse is coming from 1 Corinthians 10 and 14. It reads, therefore, my dear friends, flee from idolatry. Do you know what idolatry means?
No, I don't.
Well, you're in good luck. Idolatry is the worship of idols. Idolatry is when you worship someone or something other than God. Does that make sense?
Yes.
So one of my questions to you, iMac and friends, is who or what do you idolize? Is it your new J's? Is it your new designer clothes that you have? What about your favorite singer or your video games? Sometimes we give these things or people more time than we give God. And sometimes people worship these things or people because they get bored and simply want rapid results. They want God on their side or on their time and not his. Dylan, do you remember the story of the golden calf?
Is that the story about the Israelites worshiping the calf instead of God?
Yes, it is. And we're going to take a look at a short clip that shows us how that happens.
After God brought the Israelites out of Egypt, God invited Moses to join him on top of a nearby mountain so they could talk. So Moses left and went to talk to God. The Israelites waited and waited until they felt like they had waited long enough. They found Moses' brother Aaron and said they were tired of waiting for Moses and they were tired of waiting for God. They told Aaron to make them new gods. So Aaron asked them to take off their gold jewelry and give it to him. Aaron melted down the gold and made a golden idol that looked like a calf. Aaron presented the idol to the Israelites and told them to worship it instead of God. The Israelites offered their sacrifices to their new gods because they were tired of waiting for Moses and they were tired of waiting for God. Meanwhile, up on the mountain, the Lord was giving instructions on how to live, but he knew what was happening down below. God told Moses,
"Go down to the Israelites. They have forgotten that I brought them out of Egypt. They are worshiping an idol made in the shape of a calf."
The Lord was angry and wanted to punish the Israelites, but Moses stood up for them.
"Please, don't be angry. They are making a bad choice. Let me talk to them."
So the Lord sent Moses down the mountain with all of the instructions they had talked about written on two stone tablets. When Moses saw them worshiping the idol, he was so angry he threw down the stone tablets and found his brother Aaron.
"Aaron, why did you make this idol for these people to worship?"
Aaron told him that they were tired of waiting for Moses, and they were tired of waiting for God, so they made their own gods. Moses took the calf idol that Aaron had made and melted it in a fire. Then he reminded the Israelites,
"It wasn't a calf that brought you out of Egypt. It was God. He is the only one that deserves your worship."
Moses went back to the mountaintop to ask God to forgive them for their foolish worship.
Okay, Dylan, pop quiz. Let me see if you were listening. Who persuaded the Israelites to worship the calf?
Let's see. It was Aaron.
It was Aaron. Aaron is who to Moses?
Moses' brother.
Good. You were listening. All right. Who brought the Israelites out of Egypt?
God.
Good job. And what did you get out of today's lesson?
That we shouldn't worship false gods and we should keep our mind stayed on God and to be patient.
Good. That's good. That was pretty good. So no one or no thing should take our focus off of God, right? God is the one who deserves our worship and he is the only God we should serve. iMac, I want you to make out a list of things that you do regularly. Beside each thing, write down how long it takes you to do it. Whatever you spend the most time on, that's how much time I challenge you to connect with God. So for instance, if I play video games for an hour, That's how much time I should spend with God instead of my video game. Does that make sense?
Yes.
And that's whether it's writing, reading God's word, and or praying. Are you up for the challenge?
Yes.
Good, Dylan. So since you're ready for the challenge, go ahead and pray us out.
God, I thank you for this day that you have given us. Thank you for all that you have done for us, God. Please allow us to keep our minds stayed on you and to keep our trust and faith in you, God. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
In Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you, Dylan. Thanks for tuning in with us today. All right, guys. Thank y'all for tuning in. Make sure that you like and share this video with your friends. And we hope to see you next time for our weekly Bible lesson. Just believe in me. Receiving me. Words that be promising. We gon' be all right. So listen.